And welcome back to the 2015 Homeless World Cup, coming to you live from the Museum District of Amsterdam. The weather has been pretty wet throughout the day, coming down in stair rods at points, so the pitches are a bit slippery, and I'm sure you'll notice that as the game progresses. So for this game, I'm also joined by a co-commentator, if you'd like to introduce yourself.
Hello, I'm Kat, and I'm originally from Germany, so I might do a little bit of German for this match as well.
A little bit of German, so we've got a little bit of German commentary theoretically for this matchup between England and Chile. But we think Kat might also stay for the next game as well, which is the men's game, which is England-Austria. So we're going to get a bit of commentary from Kat for this match, and then we might also get a bit of commentary for Kat for the Austrian match as well, because that German might come in handy if we've got any Austrians tuning into the live stream. Just to check some of the results here that have come in from England and from Chile. Chile, of course, one of the most fancied teams in this tournament in both the men's and women's competitions, being the holders of both Homeless World Cups for both competitions, that's the men's and the women's, winning it in Santiago last year. England have had a bit of a tough start to the tournament so far. This England women's team have lost 14-1 to Mexico, another incredibly strong side. They've lost 5-4 to the USA in what was a great, hotly contested match. And then they've lost 7-1 to Denmark, which we saw that game on pitch one here yesterday. Chile have had a bit of a strange start to the competition, beating USA 11-0, beating Finland 9-1, but then losing 6-1 to that strong Mexican outfit. That'll have been a great wake-up call for this Chilean side. Now, we'll run through the players as the game progresses, but one Chilean player that you need to keep your eyes on is that little number four up front. Rojas is an absolutely excellent striker. She's been powerful. This is Rojas Llanas, number four for Chile. She's a bit of a weapon up front. If they get the ball to her, she's got very strong, solid feet and a very powerful shot. And we're underway. So we've already got Douglas, number 11. And England have already scored, wrong foot in the Chilean goalkeeper. What were the chances of that, Kat?
That's amazing. What a start.
I mean, to be honest, this Chilean side are one of the favourites for the entire competition. And I feel, unfortunately, that England might not be able to capitalise on that beautiful start. But it is a great beginning. This is Rojas with the ball back inside. But Chile got a bit of space here. Chile are very good with the ball at the feet. They are able to hold. But Mexico really undid them with a very fit, comprehensive performance yesterday. Bit of a wake-up call, like I say, for this Chilean side, but we did come here very well fancied. Good closing down, though, by England. England's goalkeeper for this tournament is Hannah Voice. Saves a lot of goals with her knees and her legs, which is a great example just there of what she's capable of doing.
Definitely. I can't believe Chile haven't scored so far.
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's the Chilean tactic for both the men's and the women's teams, and a tactic that I think works really well in the entire tournament, is to get that ball crossed across that giant orange semicircle, and that's the opening Chilean goal. While I'm rabbiting on about semicircles, Chile have absolutely smashed in a goal from the centre. Excellent work from the little number three striker. So for number four, we have Stephanie Rojas Llanas. We have number three, Macarena Conesso. Conesso, the scorer of Chile's first goal there. And I believe also on the field, we have the number four or the number six, Karen Mendez. But I will confirm that for you in a second. Douglas up front for England there. Sarah Douglas, the number 11, has scored a couple of great goals, but you're really looking in the England women's team for McDonald. When McDonald's on the field, she runs her blood to water for this side. Again, Chile really able to control possession on this three-on-two situation, giving some space for the number two of Chile to get a bit of a weak shot off, you'd kind of say. That's Janet Salgado. So we've got Salgado, the number two for Chile. Bit of space there. Would you say that was blocked with the arm there, Kat?
I'm not sure. That was pretty quick.
Quite a fast pace of play, but I really say there was a bit of an arm in there. Bit of a defensive effort, though. Great sliding tackle, though, to capitalise on what was quite a slow and weak pass by the Chilean forwards.
I mean, obviously, England have quite a bit of support at the moment. There's Harry Redknapp and Farrell Williams are on site supporting England, so they might feel emboldened by that.
Yeah, we do really need to talk about that. Farah Williams, who herself has been homeless in the past. We'd like to talk about that with her. That's another great strike, though, by Chile, playing that ball at great little triangles across the box. No chance, really, for Hannah Voice to do anything about that. But yeah, of course, Harry Redknapp's been taking selfies, I've just noticed, especially some of the Northern Irish team before I came into this coaching room. It's been really nice to see a coach of his standard being able to talk and meet with some of the England players, and I'm sure players from the other teams, especially the home nations as well.
Oh yeah, definitely. It makes such a difference to the players' confidence.
We've had celebrity appearances, of course, before. Colin Farrell did meet the Irish team. Of course, the Irish goalkeeper, 17-year-old Bland, didn't actually know who he was, apparently, when they did meet him, which is incredible. But he also operated Bruce Grobbelaar wobbly legs for a penalty and has never heard of Bruce Grobbelaar. So is he, there you go, that's a typical saving style there by Hannah Voice. And also, great job to stay in her own area, but a bad pass out, and she's gathered that well. Voice recovering from some pretty weak efforts at times. Now, what we've got, I think we've got McDonald on there with the hair up in a bun. McDonald's a really, really efficient runner, and she will close down this Chilean attack that really needs to happen, because with the ball at their feet, they are quite a strong attacking unit. Calares, the sort of not very highly challenged Chilean goalkeeper there. She had a lot of trouble in the Mexican match, of course, but other than that, she's only letting one goal outside of that game. Again, well done by Rojas in space.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please.
There's some encouragement there from the English sidelines, and I think that is right. England do need to relax, keep the shape, and then press onto this Chilean attack. The more time they give them, the worse it'll be for them, I'm afraid. Neat, calm strike by Stephanie Rojas-Yanes there. Each game in this tournament, if you're just joining us, I know we've had a gap in commentary of about an hour. If you're coming back onto the game, each game's about 7 minutes each half, with a minute in between. We have quite a quick turnover, although there has been some really heavy rain, so we are slightly behind schedule as to what's on the website. We're about 20 minutes in, so this game would normally be the Austria-England men's game, but we're currently on the previous game on our schedule, which is England versus Chile. Another great stop by Hannah Voice with the legs there. Rojas-Yanes, wide, great save again by Voice. I think what you'll notice, Kat, in this tournament is that a lot of high-scoring games have actually, the goalkeeper that's letting all those goals has actually been quite good, because they've been under so much pressure that you'll find goalkeepers like Voice is a great example. She'll save two-thirds of what comes out, it's just that she's having a lot of balls struck her way.
Definitely, I think she's doing a really great job so far. It's grandfather Norman.
Somebody's grandfather Norman in the stands there. I'm not quite sure who that would be. But it's nice to see Norman attending the Homeless World Cup 2015 in Amsterdam. Give us a shout out, Norman, if you see us in the stands at some point. The two of Salgado. Salgado's really been good with the ball out of feet, I think. See Salgado again versus Voice, and unfortunately Voice wasn't really able to stand up to cope with that attack. We saw some frustration creeping in for England yesterday. They had quite a tight affair with the United States, and it was a bit of a harsh loss, to be honest. Salgado. Toconeso in the centre. But England have it back. Not a bad effort by McDonald. A bit ambitious, would you say?
It was a bit ambitious, but I think you know, at this point in the game, I think ambition is what they need, to be honest.
Yeah, because there's not really had that much sort of control of possession. And when you don't have this, that's the referee blowing for the end of the first half there. When you don't have that much control or possession in a game, it is, of course, very, very difficult to get those shooting opportunities to really test Calares in the Chilean goal. So, I mean, 5-1 to Chile, of course. What will happen in this tournament is these groups will split in half at the end of today for the men's game, and I think tomorrow for the women's game.
Yeah,
by the end of
right.
tomorrow. We've got a bit of a short schedule on Tuesday, haven't we?
Yeah, I think so. So we only have a half day tomorrow with some activities for the players in the afternoon so they can get a bit of a chance to chill out and socialise with each other.
Yeah, there's going to be a bit of a chance for them and I suppose some of us in the commentary team to get acquainted with Amsterdam as a city as well, that we haven't really been able to do yet.
No, we really haven't. I mean, we've mainly been a bit on site and in Volendam where the players are staying and where the volunteers are staying.
A lot
as well.
Of the I've been describing Volendam where we're staying. It's about 30 minutes north of the city, isn't it? Very, very picturesque, beautiful traditional Dutch town, like a harbour sort of marina city. And we're staying with the athletes in what's kind of like an Olympic village, really, or like a Commonwealth Games village, the sort of thing you would imagine from those types of events.
Oh yeah. So it's quite quiet, really. So we haven't. So we're kind of being sort of shuffled about between the site and Volendam, and we haven't really been able to explore much in between. So tomorrow will be hopefully a chance to do that.
Yeah, I think it's great because some of these teams, we need to really be honest about this, but some of these teams have never left their home cities. Some of these players. They've left their home cities, some of them, and what we're now seeing is people that didn't have passports 6 months ago who have now travelled all, from all over the world to Amsterdam for this game. So that chance to see a little bit of Holland, a bit of Dutch culture, is quite vital for some of these people.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, some of them might not ever get the chance to even come to Europe again ever in their lives, so that afternoon will be really precious to them, I think.
And especially especially before the rain started and we had some of the home nations on, the crowds that have been at these games are bigger than anything I've ever played for in any league, I must say that much. You know, the whole Boys Sunday League isn't that well attended, I must say.
And obviously Amsterdam is a really diverse city as well. So, I think I've seen some South African people from with a South African background. They came out in full force yesterday.
Well, there were some South Korean flags waved this morning as well.
Oh,
very
nice.
The South Korean game. Some, I don't know if they were locals, tourists, or people. I've no idea. Maybe people that have come with the team. But there was some great spot for the South Koreans, and that must be thousands of miles for somebody to get across for that. It's another great effort, though, by Chile, moving that ball really well across the box. The number two, Janet Saldado, has been really controlling that central position and able to feed her many the side. It's a bit of a shame for Hannah Boyce that crept in on her near side, but I must say the pitch has been extremely slippy. It's very impressive that these players are still actually on their feet for parts of this game. Saldado, back into the centre. Substitution there, Nicolas Soto, number seven on for Chile. So twin space on the left, chosen to go on short. So Dado got a bit of time there, could have done a bit more with that, would you say?
Yeah, definitely. There was lots of space there.
I mean, I think it's key for any goalkeeper, when they've got a big area, to be able to close down that angle, encroach upon the attacking player, and really get control back in the game. It's not bad, though. It's a nice little opportunity for something,
yeah.
Although the Chileans have really closed McDonald down over there. Great support from the England, though. What a great little voice there for just to support Lauren McDonald as she was kind of ice hockey style power drive into those balls to a small extent, I suppose. Back to Soldado. McDonald must stay in her own half, so McDonald isn't able to help that defensive effort. The defensive efforts are always 3-on-2 in this tournament. Maybe a little bit more movement from Mason and the rest of the English defence. Could possibly press onto the Chileans. They've got nothing to really lose by pushing forward onto those attackers.
Oh no, definitely not.
Of course, England bringing a men's and women's team to this tournament. So a lot of the time when you get one team, you'll find the others in the stands. The Welsh men's team, an incredible voice, watching Wales take a great victory against Sweden earlier on pitch two during our break. I was able to catch a lot of that game. The chance of Fluffy Sheep Are Wonderful came from the Welsh at some point. I wasn't really sure they were particularly discerning about the type of sheep, but apparently, according to the Welsh men's team, they definitely are. Again, another reasonable effort by Soldado, but she needs to just take a bit more time. Chile have got that time in the box. Acres of space, of course. The Chilean movement's been very, very strong. You can see why they're one of the favourites for this women's competition, right?
Oh yes, I mean certainly. I watched them last year as well, and they were very, very good then. But I think they might be missing a little something without the support of the home crowd this year.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the Mexican side have been really, really strong at points. It's good by Willis in defence to dispossess there, but McDonald is sort of trapped against those boards. course, things like time wasting are often heavily discouraged. Not bad by Willis. Great positional play there. Unable to really get her feet on the ball. And that's an excellent counter-attack by the Chileans. And that's a great goal by Nicolas Soto, the number seven. Soto again. It's Cathy Del Rey, the number five, on the left wing closest to our camera. And number two, Janet Salgado, still on the pitch there. Not a bad effort by Ray. She's just lurking on the outside of the box there, but Hannah Boyce is able to reclaim it. McDonald on her own. You can see how heavily the rain's coming down now. Our stadium, for anybody who's watching in Holland and fancies braving the weather, our stadium's just behind the Rijksmuseum and the Van Gogh Museum, here in the sort of Museum Plat central area of Amsterdam. Yeah, it just behind you there, you can actually see the Rijksmuseum. With 2 minutes left in this game, we've got England 1, Chile 7. But that is in no way a disgrace to this England side. They had a great game against USA. And when this tournament streamlines in the next couple of days and the teams sort of match a bit more on ability, I think this England side could really cause some upsets. So great turn and a great shot. Again by the number two, Janet Salgado. I think Salgado for me has been the standout player for Chile. Would you say that?
Yeah, I think so. She's been doing really, really well.
I mean, they've been working, often they'd work on Stephanie Rojas-Yanes, who would be sort of a great forward unit for them, because she's got a very solid pair of feet, a very good centre of gravity, and she's put in some great goals for them. But she's barely played much of this game. They've been relying a little bit more on Soldado and a few other players, and they've reaped the rewards from that, I think.
I mean, of course, the programmes that these teams come out of are very, very different in their emphasis. Which kind of has an effect on the ability. So England are very, very proud on the fact that they place a lot of emphasis on personal development, life skills and all of that. Whereas I think Chile are a bit stronger on the footballing ability and the general sporting skills.
Yeah, I mean, it depends. Like, the focus of this can very differ. Great save by Hannah Boyce, then again with her legs. Because as we enter the last minute of this game, and we can pretty much guarantee a Chilean victory here, what we really need to say is that, yeah, the South American teams and the Latin American teams do focus on the football side of things a lot. We're taking players a lot more from, like, the street kids, would you say? People that have grown up on the street can kind of happen a lot more in the South American and Latin American teams comparative to the European sides.
Yeah, that's kind of the main difference between them. I mean, obviously, Chile, they do amazing work as well. They work with prisoners, for example, and they do great work building their social skills through football.
Because, of course, there's a lot of homelessness in Chile based upon people that have left prison and been able to, had trouble reintegrating into society. Is that correct?
Yeah, but they also Football Calle, the program in Chile, they work directly in prisons and they actually go in there and work with them there. So, obviously, it's always a different emphasis between footballing skills and social integration depending on the program and the local context, really.
Of course, yeah. And so next up, and hopefully we should have a little bit more extra commentary and even some commentary in Cat's Best German as well, if we've got a little bit of time for that.